Hello, this is M. Today I am playing World of Tanks and I will be talking about each tech tree and we'll be showing gameplay of the German tech tree. Especially we'll be talking about the German tech tree. Let's see how it goes. I haven't played this game a lot. I mean, you can see I only have like GS6, GS7 tanks, and that's with the German deck tree. And I just love the German deck tree because I know what's in the end of it. You get some of the best tanks that there are, like the Mouse and the E100, and also the Yak Panzer and the Grill. I just love these tanks, and I can't say they are the best because I haven't played with them, but I hope to play with them as soon as I can. Let's see how it goes. Some of the tanks that I've been playing are this VK301P and the VK36.01H and also the Yak Panzer. These are some of my TSX tanks which I've been playing a lot. And yes, the grind is now it's a bit hard. I know getting to the Mouse is you have to go through Tiger P and a lot of tanks that are not the best, I guess. I mean, there are better tanks at tier for tier, and I think the UK tech line is also quite good. I have played some of it. The light tank tech line is the best in my opinion because you get the Cromwell, the Comet, and they are quite literally best tier for tier tanks, and you can have quite a lot of fun playing them. And the anti-tank line, you get one of the best tanks in the game at the end, the Death Star FV215B183. That's the Death Star. You have to grind that line to get to that. And that's what you got to do if you want that. The heavy tank line, UK, for UK is not that good. I mean, you do get the Conqueror, that's a good tank, but I mean, I'm still stuck on the Churchill, it's just so slow. I can't do anything with it. Anyway, let's go to the Soviet line. I haven't played too much of the Soviet line, and yeah, I will be talking about every single line in the every single tech tree in this video, which might be boring, but if you like this game you would probably want to see which tech tree is the best. Okay, so with the Soviet line, let me give you some of the things with this line offers and what are the good tanks in this line. I mean, you are definitely playing for the tier end tanks, which in the Soviet line, some of the best tanks are the Object 140 and the IS-7 and IS-4. Those are quite good tanks, but the problem with the Soviet line, I think, is I haven't played much, but the tank destroyers are not that good. I mean, the German tank destroyers are better, and the heavy tanks, they are fast in a straight line. I mean, not too fast, I mean only like 30 km per hour, but they have really bad turret traverse and track traverse. If you don't know that, it's simply how fast a tank could turn, and they can't turn at all. I mean, the scavy one, I've been playing with it quite a lot, but it's just such a slow tank, you just can't turn it. And I know other tanks, some of the other tanks are quite overpowered, like this KV-2. I know that tank is just so overpowered. And what can I say? I wish that KV-2 actually led to that IS. But who can do that? Anyway. And the light tanks, I don't know much about the LTTB is a really good light tank, but I don't know too much about the light tanks. Actually, the light tanks merge into this line, so there's not much point in trying to go through the light tanks, I guess. I don't know. Maybe then you have to grind less on the KV13. I don't know. Let's talk about the US tech tree. I was just saying tech tank tree for some reason. Anyway, the US tech tree, I haven't played too much of it, but it's a fine tech tree. I mean, I've got a tier 4 and I've seen a lot of videos. That's where I'm telling you what to do and not to do, what not to do. Anyway, the T10E T1105 E5 is actually a really good tank, and also the tank destroyer E3, that's really good. Those are the N tier tanks, and I don't know much about the T110E4 and the T57 Heavy because I haven't seen any videos about them, but the light tank line of US is really good in my opinion because I have sometimes struggled against them. So what can I say? There's also autoloader line in the US, so you can go through that too. I don't know much about that. I haven't played too much about the autoloader line. The tank destroyer that US offers, there are quite a lot of tank destroyers that US offers. I don't know too much about them, but this one looks like the Batmobile, to tell you the truth. But anyway, I think the US tank tech line is not that good, but there are some good tanks in this tech line, but not every tank is going to be good in this tech line, so you might be better with the German tech line. Yeah, I'm telling that again. Anyway, let's go to the Japanese, or is this okay? Yeah, Japanese tech line. Yeah, it has a single tech line. That's a tech line's problem. There are not a lot of tanks. There's the STB1 in the end. I don't know if these tanks are too good. I've came there across them quite a lot, but haven't been sure how good they are, so I wouldn't say a lot about them because I don't know how good they are. Anyway, let's get to the French tech line and I have something to talk about, at least about them. The tank destroyer, French tank destroyers are not good. They are literally going to eat you alive. They are not good. You will be farming them and it will be so repetitive. And I mean it will be pure anger and hatred towards them. So don't play that tech line. I know it from the videos, not my own opinion that much, but anyway. The medium and the heavy tech line, which goes through the middle, is the one which I think is the best tech line for French tanks if you want to grind through them. Yes, and you get the AMX-50B, which is a really good tank, and there are some really overpowered tanks like the ARL-44, which for tier 40 have some of the best guns, and they are quite devastating. And the AMX-40, yeah, now let's get to the light. I'm saying that in commas, because when you start with this line, it's nothing but light, because they have lowest mobility till tier 4, and then you get some of the fastest tank in the game, which are autoloaders of course, and quite fast firing, but not that good because they do not have quite that good guns or that good aim. I think they are just fine, and you get the Bataillon, which is in this game, in normal world of tanks, it's a medium if I'm good, but over here it's a light tank, who knows why, but it's an autoloader and it's not OP, it's not that good. Okay, let's talk about more detail about the German line. The thing about German line is you sacrifice mobility for quite good gun and some of the best armor that you can get. I mean, the mouse is literally one of the most armor beasts in the game. Yeah, it is the IS-7 and some other tanks, which might be as good as the mouse, but I don't know. The mouse is truly a beast. And even the E-100 is quite a good tank, and the Yak Panzer and the Grill. Let's continue. I was going through the German deck tree. I was telling you how good each deck line of German deck tree, and we'll be showing some gameplay. We'll be doing it shortly, okay? First, the topmost tank destroyer deck line. It starts with the Death Toaster, if you call it. PZSFL IVC. I don't even pronounce it fully. I haven't grinded that too much, but I think it's a fine tank. I wouldn't say too much about it, because it's the Death Toaster. It has no armor, as you can see, literally no armor. It's quite fast, and with the top gun, it's quite a good tank, but I don't know. It's just, if something gets you, you're one shot. A light tank could kill you, literally. Like, one shot. Not one shot, but could circle you and kill you. Probably. And let's get to the Nash Hunt. That's the next tank. I would say it's a better toaster or microwave. I call it the death microwave, because this tank also has no armor, quite literally, and you can't even upgrade the armor. It does have a better gun with better penetration, and it's fine. Its aiming time is fine, and has got one of the largest view range that I could find. Tier 4 tier, yeah, but I don't know. I haven't grind through this line too much. I think I won't be able to show you the gameplay. That would be in the next video, but bear in mind, I will only be trying to making videos for 20 minutes or smaller, because the upload time will be too much if I make them longer than that. Anyway, let's get to the next tank, which is a tier 7 Saint Emil. It's literally a bigger, dicker Max. Yeah, this tank. This is a premium tank, and if you are playing the Saint Emil, it's literally a bigger brother of that tank. So it's a fine tank. I wouldn't say too much about it. I haven't played it, but a lot of videos. Then you get really good tank. The Rheinmetall Borsig Panzer Waffentag. Rheinmetall Borsig Waffentag. Yeah, now I've pronounced it correctly. It's one of the best tier for tier tank, and has got a really, really good gun. You can see 800 alpha damage. I mean, what to say? With the high explosive, you could quite literally one shot a lot of the things. I don't know if it's the best tier 8 tank destroyer. I wouldn't say that, but it's a really good tank for you to get, and I hope you get to it. I mean, you have to grind through these dead toasters and the bigger dicker. Yeah, but Rheinmetall is fine. And then you get another tank, Waffentiger of Panzer 4, which I think is a fine tank. I haven't seen a lot of videos about that, so I would just say it's a fine tank. Then in the end, you get the grill, whatever you have to say. It does not have the armor or anything, but it does have a really good gun, quite a good mobility, and quite a lot of alpha damage right there. And I mean, this higher tank destroyer line is literally a kitchen stove, from toaster, microwave to a grill. You go through everything. Anyway, now let's get to the lower tank destroyer line, which I think is a really good tank destroyer line. I love these tank destroyers. We'll be talking really fast, cause don't have enough time. The video will be too long. Then the Yak Panzer 4 that I'm grinding through now is a really fun tank to play, and the Stug 3G was also really, really a good tank. Then the Yak Panzer, I don't know how good it is, but I think it is good. And then the Yak Panzer 2 and Yak Tiger, and In the end, you get your perfect reward, your Akpanzer E100, which is considered as one of the best tank destroyer tier 10, which I think is one of my favorites. Tank destroyer, of course. And then you can have the Ferdinand in the way, which is said to be a smaller Jagdpanzer E100. I think it looks like that, but let's see. I haven't played this or played against that, so we'll see. And then you can see you have to go through the heavy line, which starts off actually over here, which is a light line. I don't know why light line starts to the heaviest tank in the game. I don't know why it is so, but yeah, there are a lot of splits and remixes, which I don't know why are there so many. And then you get the VKP and the VK3601H. Yeah, the PZ4, which leads to both of these tanks, is a really, really good tank. I really love it. And also that VK301H, that's a really good tank. I haven't grinded through the lower line, which is the light line of this German tech tree. Why I haven't gone through that is because simply, I don't like light tanks. They get destroyed too easily. Yes, I will be on the contrary to the Cromwell, which I am enjoying in the British line, which is just fantastic. But I know the Leopard in this line is really good tank, and the IPIC Spice, which I will call it, is really also a good tank, and the Leopard one, which it leads to, is also really good. But I just hadn't had the time to grind through them, so it's okay. Now let's talk about the heavy lines. The VKP, which is a medium leading to the heaviest tank in the game. I don't know why it is so, but it's so. So you have to grind through the VKP and the VK301H, which both of them are fine tanks. I think the VKP is a better tank. It has literally the same armor and everything, but it's more mobile and has, I think, a better gun. But the Tiger 1 is better than the Tiger P, quite a lot better than the Tiger P. But if you want the mouse, you have to grind through the Tiger P anyway. So, and if you want the E100, which I guess both the mouse and E100 are really good tanks, I think the mouse is better because it has better armor than the E100. I would really prefer if you're going for the mouse rather than the E100, because the cheeks of the E100 are really, really weak. It's, what can I say? You have to grind through the Tiger 2 and the E75. And then get to the E100, which is your tier 10. And I will be grinding through them and will be showing most of these tanks in my replays sooner or later. And then you get to the lower line, which I'm still going to get the VK3002M and the Panther 2, E500, E50M, and might be getting the Leopard. Okay, sorry for the weird cut. I had a call which came, so I had to cut that out. Anyway, I was talking about the lower line and getting the Leopard. I think that might be fine for you, and getting the Royal Metal, Boss, again, everything. You can have quite a lot of fun in the German line. The problem with, let's talk something about Soviet line also in this video, if we are talking about everything. The problem with the Soviet line, I think, is the aiming time and the accuracy on some of the guns. I mean, I literally mean KV-2 over there, because that thing's a monster. It could one shot a lot of tier 5s, and tier 6 is also, I think KV-2 is just overpowered. I would be getting KV-2 as soon as possible to show some of the most laughable videos for you. And we'll see. For now, I'm signing out. Bye. Thank you for watching. Yeah, if you don't like any quality about this video, please comment in the comment section below. Bye.